Hello guys, welcome back to another video. Today we are doing SCP-2008 tips and tricks, so let's get right into it. Okay, so the first tip is to build a base. This is pretty obvious, as you can see here. I think this is someone else's base. I'm not gonna go on it, but pretty much just make a base. It's how you survive. It is like the main part of the game. You can do that by moving furniture around. And there are two main type of bases. There are ground bases, which are bases built on the ground, and sky bases, which are bases that are usually built on pillars like these that are elevated above the ground. It depends on which type of base you would like to make. They both are good, but it's really up to choice for that one. So let's move on to tip number two. Okay, and for the second tip, you should build your base right near a cafeteria, like right here, or a medkit area, like right over there. This is important because you need food and medkits. They're like requirements, usually, because then if you run out of energy, you start to die, and you need medkits just in case you lost some health. And this is good to know because every Monday and Friday, food restocks. So every Monday and Friday, you can just go to these areas and get food for your base. And if it's right by there, it's a lot more efficient. You can check what day it is by up top. Okay, for the third tip, this is not really a tip, but it just pretty much talks about important things you need to know. Blood nights and foggy days. Blood nights happen every, like, 10-ish days. And on blood nights, SCPs are stronger and faster. It is super dangerous to be out on blood nights, to always make sure you're in your base on blood nights. They happen every like 10 days, like I said. Foggy nights, they happen every 15 days, and it's a normal day, just SCPs can attack you, but they're a lot slower and weaker, so it's not that much of a threat. Waypoints, they are super helpful. They pretty much just show so where something is. For example, here, I'm gonna make a waypoint right here. It can change the color, the name, the icon. So it can show names for distance. Say I create it. See, it'll spawn right here. As you can see, right where you placed it. And this is super helpful because then you can always see so where it is. For example, you might want to place one at your base because if you ever die, you can always go back to your base and you'll never lose it. You also want to use this for cafeterias and medkit areas, just so you can go there if you're not near one, which you should be, actually. And the last tip is properly to buy the watch game pass. It's super helpful. As you can see here at the top of my screen, it shows the amount of time before it turns to night. This is super helpful because it can make you prepare for just when it's about to turn to night. And it only costs 8 RBX. It's pretty cheap. You can just, knowing how there are like so many like donation games out there now, you can just get a super easily. It's only 8 Robux. It's pretty cheap, so it's not that hard to get, and I totally recommend getting it. It's really worth it. And that's all. I hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching, and see you later.